the Netherlands. This city has been adopted by Albany, New York. The first of 600 tons of material has reached its destination. Jan Wewick, born in Nijmegen, now a resident of Albany, is returning to his birthplace with the Mercy cargo to be welcomed by Burgomaster Charles Hustings. Mr. and Mrs. Wewick are addressed by the Burgomaster.
But in this case, I undoubtedly speak in the name of all the inhabitants of my town, when I thank you from the bottom of my heart for all that has been given. Even a proud Dutchman can enjoy the...
And Mr. Wewick replies in English and in Dutch.
Citizens of Nijmegen, it is indeed a great honor to me, a native son, to have been given the privilege to deliver to you in person, in the name of Mayor Corning of Albany, the first shipment of much-needed articles...
...dat zij nergens op hun veldtocht door Europa zo hartelijk zijn ontvangen... ...en zo liefdelijk zijn ontvangen als in Nijmegen.
In the shadow of the famous Nijmegen Bridge, the winches begin to turn... ...and the first of five crates are lifted from the barge Nijmegen III, which has borne them from Rotterdam. The contents consist of wearing apparel, much-needed building material, lumber, window glass, cement, and assorted tools, articles which are lacking all over Holland. The Burgomaster, Mr. Wewick, ascend to the top of the crate, and the first parcel is removed. Incidentally, this is sorely needed footwear. Gentle hands remove more of the parcels to a van. And while Nijmegen residents look on in gratitude, others prepare to unload the balance of the shipment. Soon this material will afford comforts denied these people for many years. As the first van load is ready, the PTT, the Postal Telegraph and Telephone Van, forms an escort of honor and proceeds to a central distributing depot. Over the car's hood, appreciative citizens of Nijmegen have draped the stars and stripes. From the quay, the official party visits Malden, the American military cemetery. Under the flags of the two nations, flowers are reverently placed on the graves of the fallen heroes whose remains rest in the country they helped to liberate.